Hey everyone, this is Julie Tran here with Rogue Yogi. And for today's yin practice, we're going to provide some gentle pressure and care for our hips. So all you'll need is a pillow or a blanket or a yoga blanket and a single block. Before we begin, let's take a seat. Take a comfortable seat. You can place a block underneath your hips so they're elevated above your knees, or you can sit on your pillow. And take your time to get settled into your seat. And we'll begin with a meditation. You can keep your eyes open, or you can gently close them. And from here, notice the quality of your breath. Without trying to fix or change anything, can you take an unbiased observation of what is going on right now? And you can keep your hands relaxed in your lap, or you can place one hand on your heart and one on your belly to notice the rise and fall with each inhalation and exhalation. Holiday season, whether you're traveling or connecting with friends and family via video conference, FaceTime, Zoom, it can be really easy to be caught up in a lot of doing. Finding that you need to get from point A to point Z in a matter of seconds. Maybe you have things planned out a certain way. And for whatever reason, some part of that plan is just not sticking. Whatever the reason may be for your tension, your stress, and you'll know you have some stress if you find your breath is shallow and quick, or if you find your thoughts just quickly darting all over the place. You can take this moment to pause. Regulate your nervous system and create that space for your nervous system to understand that things are okay despite things going differently than what you planned. You are still right here, right now, re-nourishing your breath. From here, take a deep inhale through your nose. Sigh out the mouth. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. One more time, in through the nose. Sigh all out. Just notice anything different with your body. subtle differences. And if your eyes are closed, you can slowly blink them open, opening them at your own pace. Your vision, take in everything that's showing up right now. And if you have your hands on your chest and belly, you can relax the hands into your lap. And while we're here, we can bring our left ear to left shoulder. Chin towards your chest, right ear to right shoulder, and the back of your head towards the back of your neck while your nose lifts up toward the ceiling, just so there's less compression on your neck. And gently bring your gaze forward. And from here, if you're sitting on a pillow or your block, you can move the prop from your seat, place it aside. And we'll begin with our first yin posture, gomukhasana, or cow face pose. So you can bring your left leg as the bottom base with the knee bent, and you cross your right knee over the left. Now, if this feels any bit of this discomfort, you can walk the heels away from your hips. You can place a pillow underneath the knees, or you can place the block underneath. So for me, I feel my knees feel better with the pillow underneath, so I'm just going to cushion the pillow right there. I'm going to walk my heels further away from my hips. And we're going to rest here for just 2 minutes to start off our practice. So find a position that you feel you can be still for the 2 minutes. And allow your pelvis to dip forward or tilt forward. You can walk your hands forward for support. If you have any neck issues, you can keep your neck neutral and gaze your eyes forward somewhere past your practice space. Otherwise, you can walk your hands forward a little more and you can relax your head down. Now we're aiming for about 50 to 70% of our range of motion, so our nervous system can feel that we are safe to be in this posture. And that's really up to you to decide where that is for you. And once you find that sweet spot, you can keep your eyes open or gently close your eyes. Making sure that there's no sensation of sharp pain or numbness. See if any parts of our body can soften. Usually at the beginning of a yin pose, we find that our tissues tell us to stop at a certain point. But the longer that we hold the posture, tissues begin to relax and belly resting onto your top thigh. Feeling a tug around the hip region and the glutes. From here, using your hands for support, bring yourself back to an upright seat. You can bring the hands by your sides. Gently bring the legs up and cross the legs. And as you place the feet side by side, you can make some windshield wiper movements. Going slowly and mindfully. And from here, we'll switch the crossing of our legs and gomukhasana. Remembering to place whatever prop you feel is necessary for today. And one side may feel different than the other. I know that this side here, I definitely feel more tension in one hip than the other. I'm gonna walk my heels further away from the hips. And when you find your ideal position, you can walk your hands forward. Those of you with neck discomfort today, you can just keep yourself in this upright seat and gaze forward. Otherwise, you can plant the hands down and start to fold over your knees. When we hold our body in these relaxing postures with some gentle pressure, and it's also when we can hold these postures for a lengthened amount of time, we can encourage the hydration of our fascia. And there's a lot of science behind fascia. Say that it's very helpful for anti-inflammatory benefits, moving with ease. Reminding yourself to breathe. And noticing if your body softens even more, you might need to walk your hands further away. And from here, carefully come out of the posture, always moving with intention and slow mindful care. Remove any props aside, uncross your legs. Make some slow windshield wiper movements. Release of the hips. from here, we'll transition into paschimottanasana. It's a little chilly here, so get some feet warmth there. So your legs can remain on the floor like this, or if it feels better for you today, you can place a pillow underneath your knees, or you can place a block underneath your glutes. And if you have anything going on with your spinal discs, just make sure to fold from the hips versus curving from the low back. So just notice your pelvis, tilt from your pelvis, tilt forward. And you can plant your hands down onto the floor. If you'd like, you can place a block between your knees. If you find that your head will eventually rest at this point. If you have a bolster, you can prop the bolster right here. So I did not travel with my bolster this week, so I'm going to just keep myself in this position. We'll be here for about 2 minutes. Under your left leg, noticing the sensation under your right leg, remembering to breathe and directing the breath. Our bellies, side body, and the low back. Feel that gentle tug where the low back meets the sacrum, where it meets the glutes. Essentially creating a gentle tug on the superficial layer of fascia. Tissues are softening. Finding if our hands want to walk forward to accommodate for the softening. Making sure there is no effort on the shoulders or the neck. Or the upper back. And from here, walk your hands, bring yourself back to an upright seat, and you can wave your feet to and fro, left and right. And from here, we'll come into janu, sirsasana. So you can bend your right knee and relax the outer side of the right leg onto the floor, or if it feels better, you can rest it on your pillow. And you'll gently twist your chest so it is facing the top of your left. your pelvis forward, so you're hinging from the hip. Plant your hands down on either side of your left leg, and we'll be here for 2 minutes. Where you feel that gentle tug, applying the gentle pressure to encourage the water to temporarily leave the fascia, but after the practice, it'll be encouraged to come back and stay hydrated for hours to days. So good for lubrication of the tissues and joints. This moment to be still, especially in the midst of being so busy. Walk your hands on the other side. And you can bring the hands behind you and lean back for a moment. Wiggle the whole leg. Just feels so juicy. I love you. Alright, so we'll switch sides. So janu sirsasana, janu sirsasana on the other side. Nice cushiony prop underneath if you'd like. And rotate your body to face the top of your right foot. Excuse me. And tilting from your pelvis. Walk your hands forward to either side of your front leg. Where you feel tug on this side. Noticing the sensations in your right hip region. Reminding yourself to rest in that 50 to 70% range of your natural motion. Giving yourself the leeway and the space for your body to soften. Letting your nervous system know that things are okay. slowly walk your hands up to your sides of your body and bring them behind you. Lean back a bit. And wiggle your right leg. And see your whole leg rotating back and forth. And from here, remove any of your props, put them aside. And we'll come into a side seated position or a deer pose. And before we rest in our deer pose for a few minutes, let's notice the sensations and the subtle movements that our legs make in a dynamic deer pose. So in deer pose, you can see that both legs are bent. You have your front leg, I'm mirroring you, so this is your left leg. Left knee is bent, and the front of the shin is roughly parallel to the camera. And then the back leg, the right leg, is also bent. And it's almost like you're making a square shape, or kind of like almost a four, figure four, but not quite. So you notice that the sides of your feet are resting on the floor. I'm going to move this pillow aside for more space. So if you were to rotate from your thighs to bring your knees up, your body is now facing the direction of your knees and continue this rotation. It's almost like the windshield wiper movements we've been doing to come out of the initial yin poses. Over in the seated position. So now you're in deer pose, but you're facing the other side. So let's bring that back. Get those windshield wipers moving. Noticing that you might be migrating away from your starting position. That's okay. And let's take two more full rounds of these windshield wipers or dynamic deer. Last full round. Notice where your eyes gaze towards as you windshield wipe. And from here, you can relax in the deer pose. And then you can walk your hands to either side of your front knee. You can relax the palms down. You can place a cushion or a block underneath the front knee or the back hip. And we'll be here for about 2 minutes. And if it feels appropriate for you today, you can come on to your forearms. You can clasp the hands together or press the palms together. And rest. Sensation in your hips. Relaxing your shoulders and your upper back. And resting your belly on your front thigh or towards your front thigh. into deer pose with the legs bent the other direction. So carefully bring the knees up. And I'm going to get back into the camera view here. So front leg, right leg's in the front, left leg's in the back. We'll come into dynamic deer pose. So let's windshield wipe the knees up. Continue the windshield wiping. Bring the knees back up. Windshield wipe. And you can keep your hands to your chest, or you can rest your hands on your hips, but you could also even relax the hands on the knees, just so you can get that sense of what your legs are doing. To the other side. Make some room for three more full rounds of windshield wipers. And two more full rounds. And last round. From here, bring your hands either side of the front knee. And you can stay here, or you can rest on your forearms, remembering to place any yoga prop that you did for the other side if it makes sense today. Remembering to relax your shoulders. Taking this moment to be still. And as you are breathing into your belly and low back, noticing your belly in contact towards or in full contact with your front thigh. Making sure that you're never holding your breath. As long as you are mindfully breathing, you can get access to those connective tissues and get the benefits of the practice. If you find yourself holding your breath, then it is a good signal from your body that you could back off just a bit. Here, come onto your hands if you're not there you. And do a few more windshield wipers. And from here, we're going to come onto our backs into supine position before we prepare for shavasana. So we're in supine position on our backs. Take a constructive rest. Knees will be wider than your hips, and your knees will rest inward. I think I said feet wider than your hips. Making sure you're not trying to make your knees wider than your hips. That would be a completely different yin pose. And notice the contact your body's making with the floor. And from here, walk your feet inward until they're butt hip distance apart. And we'll take a figure four. So cross your right ankle over your left thigh. You can stay here, or you can press your right hand into the right thigh, adding a nice, gentle pressure. And from here, take your left hand and interlace the fingers with your right toes. Now, this may be unusual for those of you that don't find yourselves doing this, but you're essentially holding hands with your foot. And if that doesn't feel comfortable, you can always just wrap your fingers around the toes. With your right hand resting on the right thigh, left fingers and holding the right foot, begin to rock your entire right leg left and right. Just small, gentle movements. And pause. And you can bring the right thigh towards your chest and move it away. Bring it towards your chest and send it away. Doesn't have to move far, just small degrees of movement. And from here, you can release your hands from your toes and feel the sole of your foot. You can give yourself a massage. Noticing every single toe, noticing the little knuckles inside the toes, the ball of the heel, the arch. And from here, you can slowly supinate, pronate